Arizona Stadium here in Tucson for this Pac-12 South matchup as the unbeaten 23rd ranked Utah Utes take on the Arizona Wildcats. Hello everyone, I'm Brian Custer alongside my partner Ben Lever. And partner, this is the conference opener for both of these programs, an important game, especially for Arizona, considering this was a program that won just one conference game all last season.
It's a heightened sense of urgency, really, for both teams. I'm really curious to see how Arizona, they're going to start and play 9, 10, 11 freshmen in this game. How they manage their nerves early on is going to be a big storyline.
Both of these programs are led by dynamic dual threat quarterbacks who can get it done not only through the air, but especially with their legs. In fact, both quarterbacks lead their respective teams in rushing.
Yeah, they're both dual threat quarterbacks, although just slightly different. Where Utah's Tyler Huntley, you know, he wants to throw the ball first. He's going to sit in the pocket a little bit more. He's going to assess the field, wants to get the ball down the field. And where he's really dangerous is extending plays on the outside, pressing the line of scrimmage, but still looking to throw the ball. And Brandon Dawkins from Arizona, he's the veteran that comes in here. He's more of the runner as much as he is a passer. We can see a lot of out-of-pocket throws, cutting off half the field, some easy reads for him. He's especially dangerous in the red zone with the quarterback run game.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Jen Hale.
Well, Brian, you and Ben were referencing the youth movement of Arizona. Certainly, this is a raw but promising young group for the Wildcats. 61 true or redshirt freshmen. That's half the squad. But many of them are already having an impact. 46% of Arizona's tackles this season so far come courtesy of freshmen. Now, Coach Rich Rodriguez tells me this is the best class he's ever recruited, both in terms of skills on the field and football IQ. So, Brian, pretty high praise.
You're right about that. In fact, he said this freshman class is special.
It's special, and he says that they all love football. He said when we went into their high schools and we talked to them and their parents' houses, we got this sense that all the guys they wanted to bring in, not only from winning programs, but they want to see how much they loved the game. And he says we found a group of guys that just love the game. They're there watching film all the time. They're working out. And he says he's found a great freshman class, and you're seeing that by how many snaps they'll get this season.
Kyle Winningham, head coach of Utah. This is his 13th season in Salt Lake City. You know, the Utes have won 9 or more games the past 3 years under him. 2008 National Coach of the Year. In fact, he has the best bowl win percentage in NCAA history. His Utah squad 10-1 in bowl games. That's a 91% win percentage.
Well, and they could be even more dangerous and more explosive this year. They added Troy Taylor. He's the new offensive coordinator, came over from Eastern Washington. We'll get a chance to see them after this first series. But they are more explosive down the field, and they still play great defense.
Mitch Wisnowski will kick things away. Best kickers in the country. Back deep, Tyrell Johnson, the senior out of Fort Myers. Fastest Wildcat on the squad. And it goes through the end zone. And let's talk about what to watch for when those young cats have the football.
Well, get to know Shun Brown. Not only is he dynamic in the punt return game, but watch him in space. He's going to be their slot receiver. They target him a lot. Very hard guy to bring down in space. And for Utah's defense, Kylie Fitz. Last game, he had a concussion. He came out. He's back this game. This is a relentless player that plays on the other side of the line of scrimmage almost every play.
Nick Wilson in the backfield alongside Brandon Dawkins. They start from the gun. And Brown, you talked about him. He gets the first carry.
And this is going to be a point of emphasis really for both defenses, is how well they tackle in space. College football now is a spread you out, get you in one-on-one situations, but you have to limit yards after catch or yards after carry just like that.
What a game Dawkins had last week against UTEP. Back to pass, and he's looking for Shun Brown. And overthrows it. And that was one of the things the coaches talked about. They loved about him that he's worked on the fundamentals, especially his footwork when it comes to his accuracy.
Well, it's all about footwork. And they say, you know, quarterbacks are really built from the ground up. And, you know, his foundation hasn't always been the best. He's kind of an arm thrower. They want him to get more involved throwing with his hips and his feet.
Back to pass again. And that pass is complete to Tony Ellison. And that's the first down. And that's Kavika Loafatisanga. brought him down.
You saw Luafatasanga, number five, come screaming in there on the blitz. You're going to see a lot of blitz from Utah's defense. They play heavy man-to-man, really challenge the quarterback and the receivers to find some windows, and they're going to blitz you a lot of times up the middle.
Utes showing some pressure, drop back in coverage. Dawkins, and that is batted away. And welcome back to the lineup, Chase Hansen.
Yeah, Chase Hansen is their safety. He missed all of training camp with an injury, played the first two games, missed the last game. You'll see him on the right hand of your screen, just doing a good job of keeping his base and his eyes and getting upfield, knocking that ball down. But he is a special playmaker, and they're happy to have him back.
Dawkins, the fake, keeps it. And he's brought down. Kylie Fitz with the tackle.
Well, again, for both teams, we talked about how do you stop a running quarterback. And they said our ends and our safeties have to play very well, containing the quarterback on the outside and doing just that. Funnel him back to the inside where all of your defense can then rally and make the tackle. It's nice execution on the outside for Utah.
Second time in this possession. Wildcats are facing a third down. They go four wide. Dawkins. And that's incomplete. Looking for Tony Ellison.
Well, just as I talked about, third down critical situations, you're going to see all these guys blitzing. He's in a green dog, where it means he has the back in man-to-man. If that back stays in, he's going to blitz. It's man coverage all on the outside. They do a good job of getting the hand and leveraging on the inside and knocking the pass down.
Jake Gladding, redshirt junior, be doing the punting for the Wildcats. Back deep is Booby Hobbs, a dangerous return man for the Utes. And that one rolls out of bounds at about the 28. When we come back, it's the Utes' turn. Tyler Huntley. Welcome back to Tucson. You're watching college football here on FS1. 23rd ranked Utah taking on Arizona. Wildcats had the football first with seven plays, punted it away. Now Utah getting their first offensive possession. Tyler Huntley, let's talk about what to watch for.
Well, his main target on the outside is Darren Carrington. Came over from Oregon, a little bit of a checkered pass, but one of the best receivers in the Pac-12. He'll get a lot of targets today.
Zach Moss, offset right, he gets the first carry. Gets across the 30-yard line. Luca Bruno with the tackle.
We look at Arizona's defense, led by their bandit free safety, Demetrius Flanagan, fouls. You know, takeaways was a big thing for this defense going into training camp. They've got a bunch already. He's got three. Look for him on double coverage to be over the top of Darren Carrington.
Looking for Carrington now. Got it at the 40. And he's pushed out of bounds just shy of midfield. Lorenzo Burns pushes him out of bounds.
They opted to go with the off coverage there. As you see the off coverage, allowing him to make that little short stop route and then get the yards after the catch. You have to be very careful when you go and press him, because he is so good with his releases off the line that he can get over the top quickly.
20-yard pickup. Hand off, that's Moss. Breaks the tackle. Moss in open field. He's brought down. Inside the 25, that's Scotty Young with the tackle. 25-yard pickup by Moss.
And this is what Troy Taylor wanted to do, the offensive coordinator, is get the running backs more involved in the run game. A lot of it comes down to the quarterback running the football, but they need to get their running backs more involved. You saw it right there, get a hat on a hat, get to that second level and get after those young linebackers that have a hard time getting off blocks, and let your young backs go and explode.
Another inside handoff. Moss again gets to the edge, pushed out of bounds at the 12.
This is an area for Arizona's defense they need to improve on in their first three games. Susceptible to a lot of perimeter plays. They're able to get their shoulders captured on the front defensive line. And again, like I said, the linebackers being a young group, they're more athletic than they are big, and they have a hard time getting off blocks, especially with a big offensive line like Utah.
Keep your eyes on Carrington. He's in the slot at the top of your screen. That's the handoff. And Huntley keeps it. He's brought down at the 8.
And really for both teams, this is what they like to do when they get inside the 20 in that red zone. It's a lot of quarterback run game. And the reason they do that is that you can now have an extra blocker blocking for the ball carrier. And it forces the defense now to bring an extra guy in the box. And it forces somebody to get off the block to make the tackle. So both teams look for a lot of quarterback run game in the red zone.
Zach Moss checks in. Huntley rolls left, looks. Touchdown! Samson Nakua with the touchdown catch. And the Utes, the first to crack the scoreboard.
You'll see Samson Nakua come right from right to left. And this is what Huntley does so well. He wants to be a passer first. He's not always looking to run the ball. So he'll break, contain, extend the plays, get into scramble coverage, and the freshman from Provo, Utah, gets the first touchdown for Utah.
Here comes Matt Gay. He has been basically automatic, not only with extra points, but for field goals as well. And the Utes go 6 plays, 73 yards in 2 minutes and 26 seconds. Samson Nakua with the 8-yard touchdown reception. Utah 7, Arizona nothing.
Samson Nakua, second on the team in receptions. 8-yard TD catch, Utah 7-0. Tyrell Johnson and Cedric Peterson back deep. Mitch Wisnowski kicks it away. And he just booms them every time back in the end zone. Let's talk about some of the keys to the game.
Well, it actually gets pretty simple. Arizona is the number one rush offense in the Pac-12. Well, guess what? Utah's defense, number one against the run. So you've got two teams that are really good at what they do. Something has to give. For Arizona to have any success in this game, like they've had the past against Utah, they need to run the football and run it well, not just with the quarterback, but with the running backs.
Those keys to the game brought to you by the Lincoln Motor Company. Second offensive possession for the Wildcats. J.J. Taylor in that backfield. Dawkins is going to keep it. Left side. First down. Knocked out of bounds close to the 40. Corian Ballard.
Well, this is how you attack the edges. Watch the pulling action by the right tackle and the right guard coming all the way over, doing a great job sealing the edge. And again, you can see Dawkins, when he gets out in space, those long legs cover a lot of ground. He picks up a lot of yardage.
So from the pistol, J.J. Taylor. Behind Dawkins, that's Sean Brown in motion. It's Taylor, right side, he gets maybe a yard. And once again, Mokafisi is right there.
It's Mokafisi and Chase Hansen. Again, we talked about number 22, the safety. You can see a lot of down safety looks because of that quarterback run game. They're gonna trust their guys on the outside to man up against the receivers, bring that strong safety down in the box for the run game just like that. Hansen does such a good job of filling the hole.
Wildcats have now run 11 offensive plays. Nick Wilson, still no touches. Dawkins throws, that's too high. He's intended for Cedric Peterson. Dawkins took some criticism a couple of weeks ago about the accuracy.
Well, and he had what he wanted. Again, it was man coverage. They ran double crossers underneath and sort of picked the defensive players. He had a man open, but he sort of struggles when he's got a moving target across his face with speed, just like on that cross you saw, the high delivery didn't set his feet.
Third and 9 for the Cats. Dawkins, he's gonna take off. Trying to get to that edge. Knocked out of bounds, close to a first down. They're gonna give it to him.
And I think he got there.
Yeah.
It was a little bit of a tightrope down the sideline, fighting off a bunch of tacklers. And at 6'3", 210 pounds, not the biggest guy, but he runs with power. able to stay in bounds and keep his feet and pick up a first down.
And a bunch set there at the bottom of your screen. That's Sean Brown. Dawkins going to keep it, though. He dies. 31.
Well, Bradley and I, number six for Utah, had outside contain. I talked about the defensive ends have to play contain very well. He got too nosy, came down the line of scrimmage on the fake handoff, and Dawkins just went right around him. He's got to play better contain on that right defensive end spot.
Dawkins looking up top, got a man wide open. That's Peterson. Julian Blackman fell down.
You know, see, Blackman here singled up against the boundary, actually loses his footing. A little bit of a push-off, but he didn't call that. But a nice job of just using the leverage against the defender and picking up the first down.
Dawkins again. The pitch to Taylor. He's knocked out of bounds.
Interesting call there as they spread the field to the right, get three receivers to the right, and actually run that little speed option flip to the boundary side, not giving the runner a lot of room to run. And Corian Ballard came up from the safety position and laid the hit.
Whoa, that one almost gets away from Dawkins. He just throws it out of bounds. Pressure once again up the middle. That was Kavika Loafatisanga.
Well, this is what happened against Houston. He not only fumbled in that game, but had a crucial bad bobbled snap up against his own end zone. It looked like he was ready for that snap. The snap looked okay, maybe a little bit high, but he needs to come down to his focus in on the snap. Don't get ahead of yourself. Just like a lot of things, step-by-step process. Gather that football, then run the play.
Third and eight from the 19. Wildcats 2 for 3 so far on third down. J.J. Taylor, the redshirt freshman, in the backfield. That pass, complete, is Cedric Peterson. And the tackle right there by Blackman, sophomore in Utah.
You'll see a lot of times as defenses will zero blitz their safety right up the middle. That means no safeties deep in the middle of the field. Everybody is manned up on the outside, and you have to do just that. The ball is caught because you're going to allow them to catch that sometimes. You have to come up and make that play and make that tackle.
Joel Pollock in for the field goal. This is from 32 yards out. He knocks it through. It's good. So the Wildcats get on the board, their second offensive possession. 7-3, your score here in the first quarter. Wildcats, 12 plays, 60 yards. Did it in 3 minutes and 41 seconds. As Pollock nailed that 32-yard field goal. 7-3, our score, just under 7 minutes here in the first quarter. Devontae Henry Cole gets the carry over that right side. Boy, he is met, stood up, driven back by Scotty Young Jr.
Boy, Scotty Young Jr. just met him face to face. A nice gain, but watch him stick him right in the face. That's such a good tackle. Using his shoulder, good technique, keeping his head away from the ball carrier. And he had a nice little stick, although they picked up 6 yards on the play.
Another freshman. He's out of San Diego. Second and four. Huntley looking left. That one's complete over the middle. Samson Nakua.
And Tyler Huntley said, if you're going to focus on Darren Carrington on the outside, well, guess what? I've got another 6'3", 190-pound freshman that I've been really leaning on that's going to pick up some of that slack. Getting open in the middle of the field, showing that he knows what to do with that football. Nice young player here for Utah.
You see Carrington right there. That is his main man, offensive weapon through the air. He's in the slot. Huntley rolling, looking for Carrington, and it's out of bounds.
You'll see a lot of that as this game plays out. It doesn't matter if Carrington has one guy plastered all over him. It could be two guys in some games already. three guys. He just throws it up. He just knows that he can go out and get that thing. That's it. Carrington's range is the thing that makes him so special. He can jump up, he can reach out with his big mitts and catch these footballs, and never seems like he's really covered.
Utah has 41 first downs on the season. 22 of them have come from Mr. Carrington through the air. This is second and 10. Huntley looking, and that's complete. Siosi Wilson, he's across midfield inside Wildcat territory. Jason Whitaker with the stop.
You know, some point in time, Arizona's really going to have to come up to the line and press these guys. Jace Whitaker is a corner on the outside, keeping about 10 yards on a situation. Look how far he's off. That's an easy throw and catch, and then making moves like that in the open field is awfully hard for a defender.
Huntley escapes under pressure, and he's sacked. Benton Connolly coming up with the sack for the Wildcats.
Boy, that just seemed like a broken play from the beginning. We got a puller. We got a lead blocker. He decides to pull it and want to run with it. And he just has no place to go. Great hustle. Look at Connolly fired up.
He's a sophomore. He's out of Gilbert, Arizona. Loss of 9. McCormick in the backfield alongside Huntley. Drops that one off to McCormick. He's brought down at the 23. Kylan Wilborn with the stop.
You know, this is something special that Utah does. You see Troy McCormick, the running back, right before the snap, he kind of runs up to the line of scrimmage. And they do that to get these running backs out in space, in pass for the checkdowns or the screens. Not a lot of teams do that, but as a defensive player, when you see that guy rush up to the front of the line of scrimmage, expect him to go out for a pass.
Huntley under pressure again, and he's sacked again.
Well, this is an area for this defense that they said we need more pressure from our young players. And they're doing just that. Rushing up the field, not staying on blocks, spinning, scrapping, using their hands to get off the blocks. And the coverage down the field is good enough and long enough where Huntley has to pull the ball down, and they get more and more pressure on him to stop him and stop that big time drive that they had going on.
Here's Matt Gay. He's 11 for 11 on field goals. Make that 12 for 12 as he knocks this one in from 41 yards out. Made a 56-yarder last week, as well as a 50-yarder. That 56-yarder, the longest in the country so far this season. Tyrell Johnson back deep for the Wildcats. Once again, Wisnowski kicks it the back of the end zone. Taylor, the carry. Marquise Blair with the stop.
Well, they made it a point of emphasis to get the running backs involved more in the run game. I think they're doing just that, sticking to their game plan, using extra guys, extra linemen on a bunch of pull schemes, trying to get that perimeter, but they are most definitely trying to hand the ball off more to the running backs and let them do some more of the work and take some of the hits off of Brandon Dawkins.
And that's the end of the first quarter. And it's the Utes with a 7-point lead. 10-3, that's our score. Second quarter, when we come back, we're watching college football here on FS1. Getting ready to start the second quarter here in Tucson. 23rd ranked Utes with a 7-point lead over Arizona as we take a look at the first quarter stats. Arizona, sixth best rushing offense in the country. Just 32 yards on the ground thus far. Utes getting it done through the air. Dawkins keeps it, and again high, in and out of the hand. Devon Cooper.
Well, once again, you get Dawkins running on the outside, and you see him just use all of his arm there. It is hard to set your feet, but he needs to calm his body down just a beat so he can throw that with more accuracy. A lot of high throws once again for Brandon Dawkins.
Third and nine. They've converted 50% of them so far. Dawkins over the middle. He's got a man. That's Tyrell Johnson.
Pass complete to number two.
He's short of the first down marker. Let's see what Rich Rod does here.
Do you try it again?
Yeah. It's again about half a yard shy. They'll go for it again on fourth down.
They see the zero blitz. They're bringing that safety down. Look to the side, change up the play.
They fake the reverse. He's got a man wide open. First down, Bryce Wilmer. The tight end who really leads this team in catches. He's got 12 now on the season.
And it's Wilma, like you said, the leading receiver, have not incorporated a lot of tight ends much in the past few years. And this year, they said because of Wilma, he's very athletic. They use him right there on fourth down, then they convert a huge play.
Dawkins keeps it, right side. Spins off one tackler. Picks up about seven. Once again, Kavika Loafatisanga. The senior brings him down.
Yeah, but you can kind of feel this momentum building now for Arizona on their offense. They know that they can play with these guys. It's big, strong Utah defense. They're able to move the football, and I feel like they're gaining a lot more confidence with every conversion.
Taylor takes one tackle, cuts back up the middle to the 10, fumbled the football. Booby Hobbs has it. He had a first down and more as Casey Hughes knocks it out of the hands of the redshirt freshman.
Well, he does everything right. Making people miss, using his blockers, cutting off, look at that. And then you see Casey Hughes, when he's spinning, just put his helmet right on the football. So two big plays by each defense when each defense needed it. That time it was Casey Hughes and this Utah defense.
And takeaways is a thing that this Utah defense thrives on, and they get one now. 10th takeaway for the Utah defense. That's Moss right up the middle. Picks up a couple.
Well, you know, in these backed up situations, 90% of the time you're going to hand the ball off to give your offense a little bit more space. And Arizona does a good job of stacking the box, getting guys down close to the line of scrimmage, and limiting any sort of run game.
Second and seven. Huntley, he's going to keep it himself. Gets a block from Carrington.
Again, we talk about edge contain. Look on the right side of your screen. They lose contain on the outside. They bring a blocker from the other side of the formation to help out Huntley, and he does the rest from there. Again, you can see the athleticism from both quarterbacks as they get out in space.
Huntley, a sophomore out of Florida. His high school teammates with Zach Moss and Damari Simpkins. Last week had career high in passing yards and touchdowns. Hands that one out to Devontae Henry Cole.
And that time a nice read from Huntley as there's two defenders both attacking him on that read option. He does the smart thing by handing off to Henry Cole. And Cole takes it from there. Another nice nifty little spin move. He's got to be careful in those situations as well that he doesn't take a helmet to the football.
Zach Moss, Troy Williams, Troy McCormick both check in. This is Moss spinning his way for a first down and more.
And I just get the feeling right now that Troy Taylor, the offensive coordinator, the new offensive coordinator for Utah, he doesn't mind some of this grinded out style of football, but I think he wants to start pressing the ball down the field. This is a good time now. You picked up a little bit of momentum. You've gotten out of your own end zone. I'm thinking some sort of big explosive play coming up here for this Utah offense.
Moss, McCormick in. And that's McCormick. He leads all the running backs of the Utes. That's his 11th catch of the season.
Boy, Arizona's defense got really lucky there. They're late to line up, and they left Carrington all alone on the right side of the formation, close to the boundary. And Jace Whitaker was just getting there in time at the snap of football. Had Huntley seen that early on, it would have been an easy pitch and catch to Carrington.
Carrington at the top of your screen. Huntley looking right, under pressure. And he's sacked. Brought down by Tony Fields, the freshman out of Las Vegas, who leads this team in tackles.
Boy, and when you talk about this young defense, these coaches say, hey, we got a good one in Tony Fields. You see him come up at the top of the screen, unblocked, another blitz on the outside. He is their best blitzer already as just a freshman. And you see that speed and you see that burst from that young player from Las Vegas.
And it looks like Troy Williams has come into the football game replacing Tyler Huntley. Huntley is lined up as a receiver at the bottom of your screen. McCormick looking, throwing, complete to Carrington.
There it is.
Down the seam to Darren Carrington.
There it is. We were just discussing, you got to get Darren Carrington involved in this game a little bit more. He's had two catches up to this point, and this is what he does best. The coverage is there. It's decent. It's a little bit of a back shoulder throw. Could have led him a little bit more, but it's the adjustment by Carrington, the athleticism to jump over the top of the defender and make that play.
First down. Williams takes off. About a yard shot. Lorenzo Burns makes the stop.
Well, in Arizona that time smartly double covered Darren Carrington as a number two receiver, and that's really what opened everything up on that left side for Troy Williams. He saw the double coverage, saw the void, and then his receivers turned into blockers, and they pick up another big gain on first down.
Keep in mind, Troy Williams was the starter last season for the Utes. 9-4 as the starter. Huntley beat him out in camp. Second and goal. Troy Williams from the gun. McCormick in motion. Under pressure, and he throws that one away.
And once again, they bring that running back up pre-snap to get him to free release through the line. They're trying to set up another screen pass. You'll see it comes right up here, right at the snap of the ball. They're trying to free release him with timing. And Arizona does such a nice job with Derek Bowles, number 99, of just spying off of him and playing that screen.
Third and goal now for the Utes. Carrington at the top of your screen. Empty set. Williams. Rolls right, throws in and out of the hands of his tight end, Vaka'iloa-Tonga.
Vaka'iloa-Tonga would like to have this one back because that is a well-thrown ball. It had some juice on it. But in a critical situation like this, being the senior, being one of the leaders on the team, you need to come up with that football. Good coverage all around. I think he's looking for Carrington up top in the seam, but once again, they double cover him, and he has no choice but to throw it to his tight end.
Here comes Matt Gay. Knocked one in from 41 yards out in the first quarter. He is still perfect on the season, 13 of 13. And the Utes extend their lead to 10. 13-3 is our score here in the second quarter. Well, thanks to a J.J. Taylor fumble, Utah goes 14 plays, 91 yards, did it in 6 minutes and 20 seconds. longest drive of the season for them. They extend their lead to 10-13-3 here in the second quarter.
Unfortunately, once again, it's a penalty as they're about ready to punch it in, first and goal, that set them back and really kept them out of the end zone. But nonetheless, a great drive for Utah.
Wisnowski again. Blue here in Tucson. The blue helmets for the Wildcats. Let's take a look at their last four possessions. Fumble, a punt. And Nick Wilson, who's yet to touch the rock, doesn't get it. It's Sean Brown. Sean Brown shakes another one. Cuts back. And he's dropped finally at midfield. So finally, the Wildcats get it to one of their offensive playmakers.
Well, finally, we get Sean Brown to get the ball in his hands and watch the little cutback right at the end of the run, right here. Whoop! That's so sweet. So hard to stop when a guy is that quick and that balanced on his feet.
Wilson. Again up the middle.
Oh, carried by number 28, Nick Wilson. Brought down by number 6, Bradley Unai.
I like what Arizona's doing right now offensively, mixing up a lot of things, some perimeter stuff, some interior runs, a pass to the tight end, really keeping this defense off balance.
I thought Kylie Fitz jumped off sides. Dawkins looking up top. That was short. He was looking for Nick Wilson. A wheel route.
See Chase Hansen on coverage. Normally the safety, in-box safety, he was actually outside, lined up on the receiver. And something that Utah is getting away from that they're doing earlier in the game is the blitz and the pressure. As you see, sort of a wheel route, trying to rub Hansen off of that route. He does a nice job of sort of dipping that shoulder and getting through that rub and making a play, but another errant throw by Dawkins.
Third and six. He's got a man wide open. It's complete to Tony Ellison. Out of bounds at the 12.
Well, that's the throw that you want to see from Dawkins. Very patient. Watch him. He actually sets his feet, has pressure in his face. And the coach has talked about when he's able to set his feet, his back foot, and then deliver the football and have some sort of base. He can be very accurate. He just needs to do it more consistently.
There's Mokafisi with the hit. Here's the handoff to Wilson. Spins, picks up a couple. Kylie Fitz with the stop. Hawkins goes to 100 yards passing.
And a lot of those incomplete passes are him outside of the pocket, throwing on the run, again, throwing with no base, just using all of his arm strength and overthrowing a lot of footballs. He looks very confident when he's in the pocket.
Dawkins, complete. That's Wilma. Wilma, in fact, he's second now in FBS among freshman tight ends when you talk about catches. Well, third down.
Third and three. I would expect Utah now defensively to dial up some sort of pressure. Watch the pressure from Utah and the quarterback run game from Arizona.
They give to Wilson. Straight up the gut. And he's dropped at the 1 yard line. Chase Hansen saved the touchdown.
Terrific job by Wilson just getting the handoff and getting upfield as fast as possible. No hesitation. He knows he only has to pick up a few yards to get a fresh four. They do a nice job on the left side, kind of opening up that gap, and he does it all the rest from there.
Arizona first.
First in goal. Wilson alongside Dawkins. Dawkins is going to keep it and walk into the end zone. Touchdown, Wildcats. Going 11 plays, 75 yards, did it in 4 minutes. Pollock is good. And we're at the half. Utah up 13-10 right now. Let's go to Los Angeles and Rob Stone.
The 23rd ranked Utah Utes up 3 over the Arizona Wildcats, 13-10 as we get ready to start the second half. Brian Custer alongside my partner Ben Lieber. And you know, both of these squads had some costly miscues in that first half. You look at the first half, it was basically turnovers.
Yeah, it was really all turnovers. I thought going into this game, we're going to see some sort of offensive explosion, but really it's the defenses that are playing very well. And it's not just the balls getting turned over, it's where it's getting turned over. Both offenses were actually going into scoring opportunities in the red zone. Coach Whittingham just very displeased with his offense, a lot of sloppy mistakes. They got in the red zone with their offense. They had a costly false start that set them back. They had to settle for a field goal. So they really need to settle down and play this second half out clean.
Utes, of course, getting the football here in the second half. Let's go down on the field. Here's Jen Hill.
Well, Brian, the injury news does not look promising for this Utah squad. Coach Kyle Whittingham told me it's doubtful either Tyler Huntley or Kyle Fitz will play again in this game. Right now, Tyler Huntley still back in the locker room. No helmet, no jersey on. That right shoulder is wrapped up. Left end Kyle Fitz left the x-ray room on crutches. Meanwhile, Whittingham tells me they have complete confidence in Troy Williams and do not feel like they'll have to tweak the offensive game plan.
Jen, thanks. So Troy Williams. And there's the handoff to Devontae Henry Cole.
Well, I think the big key to that report by Jen was the fact that they don't feel like they have to change their offensive game plan. And you wonder, with the new offensive coordinator, Troy Taylor, coming in, wanting to be a little bit more high tempo, throwing the ball a little bit more, that's the reason why Troy Williams lost the job in training camp, is they didn't feel like he had a high enough ceiling throwing the football and being sort of a dual threat quarterback. But obviously they're going to stick with their game plan here. They feel like he can run their offense, and it's better to do that and stick with it for your offense than to try to change things up and throw them out of whack.
Cole and another carry, another first down for the Utes. Your offensive coordinator Troy Taylor looks on. Carrington, top of your screen in the slot. Williams, that's complete. TLC Wilson, he's got a lot of room to run. He's inside Wildcat territory at the 40.
Well, that's been the philosophy going into this game, was Arizona's gonna allow them all this space, all this cushion to the outside. They understand that there's a lot of playmakers for Utah on the outside with a lot of speed. They don't want to go over the top and get burnt. They'd rather just give up the underneath pass, come up and make the play, which they didn't there. But that's been the philosophy. It's actually been working most of the game.
21-yard pitch and catch. That's McCormick in motion. William steps up, fires right side, out of bounds.
William's back.
He's looking for Siosi Wilson.
Siosi was just on an outside comeback right about the sticks. And it was about a second too late. He recognized it, had the separation, and it was just late throwing the football out there, and he threw it wide.
Here's Williams. He goes up top. It's complete to Raylan Singleton. Singleton, 6'3 junior out of Crosby, Texas.
And once again, as we talked about coming out of halftime, was just a lot of miscues for Utah on offense. They had the turnovers, they had the false start in the red zone, and again, they had a nice drive going on, and then they have two big offensive penalties that set them back and just killed their momentum.
Third and 18. The Utes 1-for-4 on third downs here tonight. Williams going up top. Carrington to Maury Simpkins inside the 5 at the 2.
What a strong throw from Troy Williams. He's got Simpkins as the number two receiver. There's a quick look off. You see that safety get pulled to the left side of the screen. And he puts that thing on the money with velocity. Gigantic third down conversion.
First and goal for the Utes.
A lot of times in situations you think that you can just sort of sneak that play on the defense, but Arizona does a great job of just digging that thing out.
Here's the touchdown. Troy Williams. We get some pushing and shoving there. Temper's starting to flare. Derek Bold.
Well, that's what you want to see. The fullback dive, not really characteristic. They try to sneak one on the defense. And this is more of what you want to see out of this offense. The fake. You get the lead back, the lead fullback there. And all Williams has to do is just take a few steps into the end zone.
Extra point. And Matt Gay is good. But all of this was set up on a crucial third and 18. Williams finding Damari Simpkins inside the five. Utah now up 10. Welcome back to Tucson. It is nice when you got a senior as your backup quarterback. They go 10 plays, 75 yards. And Williams scores 20-10. You score. It's Wisnowski. Kick it away. This is Tyrell Johnson. He gets across the 30. Bear down. It's a rally cry here at this university, and its roots really a century old. Arizona football player, student body president John Button Salmon, gravely injured in a car accident back in October of 1926. The coach at the time was J.F. Pop McHale. He visited Salmon in the hospital before his death, and later he told the football squad that the young athlete's last message to his teammates was, quote, tell them, tell the team to bear down. It's become the rally cry, the slogan, the battle cry here in Arizona. You can see it's on the field. Statue. Now let's see if this offense can bear down. They run the jet sweep and Sean Brown. Tyrell Johnson.
And there he is again, Luafatasanga, making his presence known here in the second half, showing that speed, that range, sideline to sideline.
Dawkins keeps it, flips it out. Tony Ellison.
And I get the sense that this Utah defense, where at the end of the first half, I thought they were getting a little bit worn down body language-wise, weren't running to the football very well. This second half, all these guys are flying to the ball, and I think that's making all the difference defensively for them.
Third and two, Dawkins going up top. And it's caught. Terrell Johnson, big catch. First down, Wildcats.
Well, if there's a guy that you want to throw the ball to down the field, there's number two in the slot, Tyrell Johnson. He's a track star on the track team. Get him going down the field. It's the body adjustment to turn back around and adjust on that football that makes all the difference on that catch.
27-yard pickup. First down from the 27. Dawkins is going to keep it. Oh, what a hit! Marquise Blair, here's a flag.
I tell you what, you could hear that hit throughout the whole stadium. The flag, I believe, is going to be for targeting.
Personal foul, targeting. defense number 13. The penalty is half the distance to the goal. Automatic first down. Number 13 is disqualified for the rest of the game.
So Marquise Blair's night is over, the junior out of Wooster, Ohio.
Well, he came in last week. You'll see it right here. Watch the head dip. As Dean was saying, he is a ball carrier. So now you're looking for the ground to help him hit. You had everything that you need to see for targeting. But that is, you talk to the coaches about him. He came in for the injured Chase Hansen last week, and he was lights out. They said he is mean, he's nasty, can be a little over-aggressive, and you saw every bit of that on that play.
So he's done for the night, and keep in mind, he's also out for the first half of next week's game. Here's Taylor. Shaped, he's dropped down to 7. Booby Hobbs makes the stop.
Well, that has not only fired up this Utah team, but it has fired up this Arizona team as well.
Second and 3, up the middle. Touchdown, J.J. Taylor. And the Wildcat offense bears down and responds.
A little bit of a deceptive play. You're going to see the polar, and then the action actually comes back this way. You get everybody thinking that you got to follow that lead back. Sort of washes down all those gaps, and it really becomes a north-south run. Very nice execution by the offensive line and the offensive line.
So the Wildcats, 6 plays, 68 yards. They do it a minute 45, thanks to J.J. Taylor, who gets in from 7 yards out. We got a football game. It's tight here in Tucson. Wildcats respond. The lead is 3 once again. Here's Williams. Throws that one out to Moss.
Williams pass complete to number 2 set.
And Williams smartly looks to his outlet. It was a quick read. He looked at Carrington on the right side. He was the number 1 receiver, running a little comeback route of about 10 yards. It wasn't there, so quickly just throws it out to a swing pass. Try not to put yourself in a risky situation and throw a pick. He'd rather just throw it out to the flare, have his receiver, his running back, pick up 4 or 5 yards.
Utah with a bunch set on top of your screen. Williams, though. That one batted down at the line of scrimmage.
Williams Bowles.
And this time the dial-up, a blitz. Marcel Yates' defense. And the perfect timing for Derek Bowles, understanding 3-step concepts. If he's not going to have time to get to the quarterback, well, then get your hands up and knock the ball down.
Oh, the crowd is in it now here in Tucson. Williams. Carrington had it and dropped it.
Williams pass is in.
He had it and dropped it. Demetrius Flanagan fouls right there.
And it's fitting. It's a third down situation at the top of the screen. He just runs that little hookup right there. And it's Demetrius Flanagan Fowles who leads this team in interceptions. Comes in there with a perfectly timed swipe at his hands to knock that ball out.
In fact, he's just one of 2 players in the country with 3 interceptions. Here's Wisnowski's punt. Again. Best punter in the country last year. That one goes 55 yards. Here comes Dawkins in the Wildcats. He's got Wilson. And he's going to keep it. Brought down at the 12.
Well, this could be a game-changing drive for the mentality of Arizona if they can drive all the way down the field and get a touchdown.
Wilson with the carry. Maybe one. Mokafisi with the stop. Third and three now for the Wildcats. Going 7 of 13 here. Dawkins throws a pick six. Javelin Guidry. Oh, those costly turnovers.
And we saw them run this type of play in the walkthrough yesterday. They wanted to use the natural pick by the number two in man coverage. And Javelin Guidry does such a good job of just staying tight on the receiver's hip, reading the quarterback's eyes and jumping in front of that football.
Matt Gain knocks it in, the extra point. A 14-yard pick six by Javelin Guidry, the freshman out of Marietta, California.
You're going to see that motion there. That indicates man-to-man. They got exactly what they wanted. They were hoping that the defenders were going to knock themselves off of the coverage, and that'd be an easy pitch and catch. But Guidry does such a nice job of staying tight to his coverage, understanding down and distance, understanding the timing of the routes as well, and jumps in front of that pass and takes it in for a pick six.
Third turnover of the night for Arizona. Wisnowski. Earl Johnson back deep. Dawkins to keep it. Stiff arm. He's brought down inside the Ute territory. The 43.
But Chase Hansen, number 22, thought he had him, thought he had the angle, but then you see just the speed of Dawkins. A little deceptive because he's such a long strider.
He's brought down for a loss, Corion Ballard. Dawkins coming into this game needed just 46 yards rushing. Passing, or really to beat Ronald Veal for the most yards rushing by Arizona quarterback. He's got 55. All day to throw. He rolls right, looks. We got a flag on the play.
I think you're going to get a defensive holding call on the back end.
I think they're going to call this one on Casey Hughes.
Holding on an eligible receiver. Defense number 25. 10-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Well, like I said, the man that had the forced fumble earlier in this game for Utah, you get in those scramble situations where the quarterbacks just extend the play, and then we would say it's become spaghetti on a plate in the back end where it's just backyard football. These receivers just trying to get over. That's really hard for these corners to stay on it.
That's the 10th penalty for Utah. Last two games, they've had 11 each. That one to Woma. The tight end. Guidry with the stop.
When Utah guessed wrong, they brought a boundary corner blitz and they ran the play away from it, but what a nice job by Guidry to come off his coverage and make that tackle.
15 seconds left in the quarter. Taylor gets a couple. Third quarter comes to an end. It's Utah up 10, 27-17. College football returns after this. Start of the fourth quarter here in Tucson. 23rd ranked Utah up 10 over Arizona. Turnovers have been the story. From the 28, Dawkins under pressure. Tried to set up the screen. comes Josh Pollock.
And Lowell Otulale, number 93, is acting like he's the one that got the block. Watch it right up the middle.
It's still 10-point advantage, Utah. Fourth quarter, Utah up 10. Let's go down to the field. Jen Hale.
Brian, both of Utah's injured players have returned to the field in street clothes. Right now, Tyler Huntley sitting on the bench with that right arm in a sling, very quiet, just watching the game. Kylie Fitz on crutches, but still sitting in on defensive meetings, trying to be an active part.
Jen, thank you. Both those guys went down in the first half. Monte Henry Cole on the right side.
Well, and not a good sign at all as we see Fitz on crutches. There's Tyler Huntley. He keeps grimacing with every little movement, sort of grabbing that right shoulder, that right pec area. Not a good sign to see your starting quarterback in the sling.
Well, the good thing is you got Troy Williams as your backup. He's a senior. He was your starter last season. Led Utah to a 9-4 record. Another handoff to Henry Cole. We take a look, and I think this is the hit here where he got injured.
Yeah, you're gonna see Tony Fields come screaming in from the backside and just sort of drive his right shoulder immediately. Watch him clutch his chest right there. He knows something's hurt. It's hard to tell really what the injury is, but obviously it's severe enough to where he's in the sling. Doesn't look good for his availability to play next week.
He's a sophomore. Again, Cole running a rock at that right side. We're a little bit under 8 minutes left here. And boy, that says it all for the Wildcat fans. Hey, listen, they can still bear down.
Don't give up hope.
Don't give up. Utah, 7 minutes, 50 seconds away from their first victory. They're hoping here inside this stadium in basically 6 years. Last time they won here is November of 2011.
And boy, they are going to just milk this clock down.
They're gonna run it down. 5 seconds on the play clock. Williams going up top to Carrington. Incomplete. Lorenzo Burns. They're in coverage. We got a flag.
I think they're going to get Lorenzo Burns for grabbing the left arm and hand of Carrington.
Pass interference. Defense number 2. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
We'll take a look at it at the top of this route. A lot of hand fighting. I don't see it. I don't know if I see that. It's equal amount of hand fighting going on. Tough call for Lorenzo Burns. I thought he had pretty good coverage.
Here's Cole. Tried to get to that edge. Dane Crookshank.
Yeah, and he probably shouldn't have. We got another injured player for Arizona. There was a hole in the middle of the line of scrimmage, and he just wanted to bounce that thing on the outside.
Moss up the middle. Crookshank again with the stop.
It's Ruatafe, number 74, that pulled around from the left guard spot that really gave him that big body to run behind. He actually sort of beat him to the point of contact. As you see Ruatafe there. Started as a right guard last year. Jordan Angasiva comes in, highly touted junior college transfer, comes in, plays right guard. So Uatafi moves over to the left guard. It's serving them well for the Utah Utes.
Reverse. Here comes Carrington. He's going to throw it. It's incomplete. We talked about those big injuries, and listen, this is crucial here for Utah. I know we're beginning the Pac-12 conference schedule, but look at what they got. They got Stanford coming up, and then you got the big one at USC. So you got two really big games for them coming up, and two of your big playmakers may be without them.
Well, they're getting with Oregon and USC on the road. Very tough. I think you wanted to see a little bit more explosiveness out of your offense, knowing that those two offenses can put points on the board.
Here comes Matt Gay. This is from 37 yards out. He is perfect so far on the season and remains so. Utah, probably the best special teams in the conference. They're up 30-17, under 5 minutes to play here in the fourth quarter. Welcome back to Tucson. 23rd ranked Utah Utes. And Dawkins goes down. That play was just blown up. Chris Hart comes in unblocked.
Yeah, Chris Hart comes unblocked. There's a nice spin move actually on the left tackle, Lathe Frick. Good blitz. Great job on first down.
Sean Brown, the catch down the sideline. Breaks a couple of tackles and another one before he's knocked out of bounds at the 44.
Boy, he just will not go down. And we've seen his balance on a lot of punt returns in the previous games, but I'm just surprised by his strength and his ability to shake off tacklers.
26-yard pickup. There's another one to Taylor. Look at this guy, spinning off everyone. Finally driven down. Let's talk about Utah's defense here tonight. A couple of blocked field goals, a couple of sacks, picks. And again, they got the 10 points off the takeaways, and they came into the night leading the Pac-12 in that category. Dawkins takes off inside Utah territory. Hansen pushes him out of bounds. We got a flag.
Well, this will be interesting. I think they're going to go for the horse collar variety.
There is no foul for face mask.
Okay. That makes more sense. But we talk about this defense again, and we'll take a look at the, it looked like his head sort of snapped that way as if it got pulled, but it never really got grabbed. His face mask was more in the shoulder, upper shoulder pad area that caused that movement. As you brought up this defense for Utah, the points off turnover, some of the pressure. I'm actually surprised they didn't apply more pressure. They pressured early on in the game. Their sort of MO is man-to-man coverage, a heavy blitzing, but they didn't blitz a lot, and they're still not blitzing a lot. A lot of that's game situation at this point, but really throughout the game have not blitzed as much as I thought they would, but they're still getting the opportunities. The pick six by Javelin Guidry, huge turning point.
Backbreaker, yeah.
Backbreaker for this Arizona offense. And really from there, it's just been catch up, and they just can't do enough explosively down the field to get the ball in the end zone.
Here's Dawkins. That one complete. Touchdown, Tony Ellison. He's got six catches, 78 yards on the night.
Well, just when I say you talk about Utah blitzing, they blitzed that time. And just miscommunication about where the spots are going to be. They find a nice little window. And Dawkins, under pressure and duress, throws a nice ball to Tony Ellison. And that's the quick strike that you need now for Arizona. They're still in this game.
Josh Pollock with the extra point, and the lead is now six.
Well, football is a game of situations, and you have to just pare everything down and break everything down into game situations. And, you know, for the small percentage that you have sometimes to have an onside kick, you still need to practice it as importantly as you do two-minute offense and four-minute offense.
Pollock and Russick. They go with the onside kick. It gets a bounce. And it looks like Arizona's got it. Ciosi Wilson was there at one point for Utah, but John Poindexter, the redshirt senior.
So deception, not him. He comes back. It's a hot ball coming right at him. And he makes the mistake of waiting on that ball. You need to go attack that ball on that second bounce. Don't let it bounce that third time. That's when it can take those goofy bounces. He decides to slow play it. What an execution job by the kicking game for Arizona, and Sean Poindexter with the recovery.
2 minutes, 41 seconds left in this one. First and 10 from the Wildcats from the Utah 35. Dawkins keeps it, 30. Strike down at the 25, and the ball's loose.
Oh boy, oh boy.
And it's Utah football.
And this has been an issue for Dawkins. He's taken some criticism for his ball handling.
Ooh, that's close.
When did that ball come out?
Yes, was he down? Let's see.
Oh, I believe he is down.
That's close.
You see Casey Hughes. See, his left arm is in there.
Four turnovers for the Wildcats. None bigger than the fumble by Dawkins. You see Schooler was trying to rip that one away from Henry Cole.
You're exactly right. Now it goes back. The onus is on Arizona. Now they know that it's going to be 9-on-7. It's the running drill that you do in practice. It's going to be a handoff virtually every single time. Now it's going to come down to rallying the guys there and then getting your arms and hands in there to try to strip the ball out.
How about that UT now? 13 takeaways this season. That is second best in the country. Second and 11. Cole over the right side. Schooler comes up and pops it. Another quick timeout by the Wildcats. Rich Rod, he told us this recruiting class of these freshmen called them special. Called this season a reboot. Now it's 3rd and 9, and he needs his young cats to get after it. Williams looking. He's going to take off. You see, he was screaming for a penalty there. But when you go head first.
Well, he wisely stays in bounds. You see the tail end of this play here. Wisely stays in bounds. And you're right. When you go head first, you are still a runner. You are not protected.
Here's Sean Brown back deep for Arizona.
And I have to imagine this is going to be a directional punt as much as you can, as much distance as you can for the Ray Guy Award winner from last year to pin them deep and get it out of bounds for no chance for Shun Brown.
Oh, almost another bad snap. Brown has already taken two back for a touchdown this season. Won't get an opportunity here. Take another look here at the snap.
Well, it has been a struggle for Alex Whittingham,
who's the son of Kyle Whittingham, the head coach of Utah. This could be the football game. 2 minutes. First and 10 from the Wildcats, from their own 25. Dawkins. Right there to Taylor, and he is brought down by Hughes.
Yeah, Hughes has had such a great game. The two forced fumbles. That time comes off his coverage and comes up, makes the clean tackle, and keeps the player inbounds.
Over the middle. Tyrell Johnson. Again, no timeouts for Arizona.
Well, and smartly, Utah's is playing off coverage right now. They're going two high safeties, nothing over the top, allowing all the short underneath passes, knowing that there's no timeouts.
Arizona needs to pick up the tempo here. Third and six. Dawkins up top, too high, intercepted. Corion Ballard. That is your ball game.
It's Ballard with the interception, but watch Pita Tonga come in here on this X stunt. They stunt both on the inside. Just wallops Brandon Dawkins. Causes the high throw. And that is game, set, match. Corion Ballard, watch this hit again.
Ooh. Yeah, Pita Tonga with the hit. Dawkins throws his third interception.
Well, what a lot of confidence, I think, gained for Utah, not only coming into this environment and playing a team that has really had their number the last 6 years, but you lose your starting quarterback. It looks like a kind of a severe injury, and your backup quarterback is now leading this team, and he did a great job tonight.
Kyle Whittingham and Utah victorious. They'll go to 4-0. Keep that top 25 ranking. Wildcats have fallen to 500 at 2-2. Brandon Dawkins, who had come under much criticism before last week's game, will certainly face some after this performance. So the final score here from Tucson, Arizona, Utah 30, Arizona 24. Right now, send it to Rob Stone in Los Angeles. More college football coverage.